Another day, another sea of blood in the Middle East. Muslim Palestinians, predominantly children and women, slaughtered. The foghorns which blared out the fake genocide of Uyghur Muslims in China now trumpet their support for an actual genocide in Gaza. As one comedian put it, the West doesn't much like the Chinese and doesn't much like Muslims, but they love Chinese Muslims. When China had a problem with the Al-Qaeda, ISIS-type Islamist fanatics, it didn't bomb the people the fanatics lived amongst. It didn't starve them, cut off their water, their electricity, or deprive them of food. Quite the contrary, China did everything necessary to convince the public of the blind alley of terrorism, and even succeeded in de-radicalizing many of the terrorists themselves. Why make so much of it now, you may ask? The Uyghur genocide is long discredited. After all, it's just fish and chip wrapping paper now. You don't hear much about the Uyghur cause now. Well, for this reason, if they lied about that, what else are they lying about? Taiwan, Hong Kong, social credit, the spy weather balloon? The British press recently revealed that China was inserting spying devices in teapots exported to the West. I'm not making that up. Besides the fact that tea bags were invented 50 years ago and hardly anybody under the age of 80 uses a teapot, just think for a moment about this ridiculous, fantastic falsehood. What could China gain from the breakfast table of Mr. and Mrs. Jones, Acacia Avenue, Milton Keynes? What possible espionage value would there be in that? This story really takes the biscuit. Western media have a whole orchestra of lies to bring in. Piece by piece, the conductor from the White House moves his baton from this lie to that, from that lie to this, and his instruments bellow forth. Bassoons boom, percussion tinkles, and brassy trumpets blare. The audience is programmed to nod along. Like George Orwell's crowd in 1984, increasingly less like a novel, more like an instruction manual, the 2 minutes of hate clears the lungs, fills the heads of the gullible. As the British rock and roll group The Who and George W. Bush nearly said, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
Fool me once, shame on you. Can't get fooled again.
Don't get fooled again.